For much of the 16th century, Spain and Portugal dominated the European overseas trade and colonization with their enterprises in the Americas. In the early 17th century, other European powers like England, France, and the Netherlands began their colonizing adventures challenging Iberian authority. They eventually succeed in creating settler colonies in North America, slave plantations in the Caribbean, and scattered trading posts in West Africa and Asia. The competition between these European empires was encouraged by mercantilist doctrine, which dictated that a robust foreign trade was pivotal for the development of their economy. In the case of the Dutch Republic, the 17th century is often considered the golden age of the empire. During those years, the country had commercial prosperity and developed a strong and original republican government system. The Dutch came to dominate the European shipping business by transforming its fishing industry into a shipbuilding machine that directly competed with the Portuguese in Asia. The Dutch East India Company, founded in 1602, was a consequence of that move, mainly motivated for the desire to monopolize the spice trade. In their expeditions in Asia, the Dutch built alliances with many local rulers who had suffered Portuguese domination for decades. For example, they assisted Indonesia, and in return, they got commercial concessions that later helped them gain political control of the country. In general, it is widely accepted that the Dutch were more violent than other competing empires and successfully spread their power due to that force. The Dutch Empire not only adventured in Asia, but they also did it in Africa, founding the colony of Cape Town in present-day South Africa and controlling trading posts in West Africa where they profited from the Atlantic slave trade. In the Americas, the Dutch directly competed with Spain, capturing territories and attacking Spanish ships. Ironically, the Dutch were tolerant and supported freedom at home, but were very aggressive and violent abroad, especially with colonized subjects. It was also in the 17th century when England began to establish its overseas empire. In 1607, they found Jamestown, and in the 1670s, English colonists from the Caribbean settled in Carolina. In the beginning, they harvested tobacco and rice, forming productive plantations in which eventually enslaved Africans replaced all other laborers. In these spaces, a harsh racial divide was imposed. The colonization of New England between 1620 and 1630 had more religious than economic reasons. Many of these colonists were radical Protestants escaping Anglican repression. These settlers later moved to other places like Providence or Rhode Island. English colonization was decentralized in nature. It did not depend on the policies of the royal crown in England as it was the case with the colonies in Spanish America. In North America, there was more colonial autonomy and diversity. The French had a different approach to their colonizing enterprise. While the Spanish incorporated the populations of pre-existing empires and the English expelled indigenous populations to provide agricultural land for their colonists, the French focused on establishing trade and diplomatic relations with tribes that remained mostly autonomous. In 1682, Robert de La Salle traveled the Mississippi to the Gulf of Mexico, opening the way for the French occupation of Louisiana. In the first decades of the 17th century, English and French sailors challenged Spain's hold over the Caribbean, which came to be relevant after 1640 with the arrival of sugar. The small islands of the West Indies became the most critical and valuable colonial possessions in the world. Trade to and among European overseas possessions was governed by mercantilist economic policy. By acquiring colonies, the European powers were increasing their wealth and power, which is why monopolies were established. The mercantilist notion of zero-sum game, in which any country gain must come from another country's loss, led to competition and warfare. As they seized and controlled new territories, the Europeans consolidated their power by dominating native populations. In this context, colonial subjects experienced the destruction of their livelihoods and ecologies while the Europeans used their resources to build empires. This is all we have for today. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.